end in 5 minutes. Just till then, we'll have an EVIC trailer played.
Right. Good evening. Thanks for coming. We'll start our event today. But just before we start, first of all, I just wanted to welcome all of you. And since many of you were not here yesterday, I thought I'll just take a minute or two to give you a little bit of an overview of what eWeek is and what eWeek has in store for you. Right. As some of you might know, about a year ago, we adopted an incubation policy, as a result of which we now have an incubation cell on campus, whose purpose is to incubate ventures that come out of the student community, faculty community, staff community, alumni community, and so on. And what eWeek tries to do is it tries to focus the campus's attention on entrepreneurship for a week. We did eWeek, the first edition of eWeek was done exactly a year ago, and this is the second version of eWeek. So every day during eWeek, there are a number of events that are organized, all pertaining towards entrepreneurship. Roughly, they're of two types. One, which is like the event that we're going to have today, where we have entrepreneurs come and talk to us about their journeys, successes, learnings, etc., and you can have a discussion with them. That's more on the knowledge sharing, experience gaining side. But there are also a series of events where all of you or anyone within the larger IIT community, faculty, staff, student, alumni, can come and pitch their ideas and look to be incubated or look to get validation of their ideas and so on. Yeah. So very quickly, what we have in store for you, yesterday was the inaugural. Today we have a My Story event. I'll let the coordinators introduce that in just a second. Tomorrow we actually have something called the Innovation Clinic, right? Which is if you have an idea, and it can be a very, very early stage idea, you can then come and present that idea, pitch it in front of some experienced entrepreneurs who will give you some feedback on how to pursue that idea further. We actually had pre-registrations for that. So most of the slots are filled up, but there are still a few open slots. So if you're interested, come to Classroom Complex tomorrow evening. On Wednesday, over at C5, we have a Student Innovation Day where students who've been working on innovative projects, either in C5 or as part of their final year projects, present this work, and you can explore commercial potential. That's also interesting because I know many of you here might want to be entrepreneurs, but might not necessarily have your own independent idea. These events are also a chance for you to meet other innovators from whom you can actually team up and start something. We have also on Wednesday and later on Friday some events that are directed at faculty, but since I don't see any faculty here, I'm not going to describe them in much detail. On Thursday, there's an event where we have student entrepreneurs or entrepreneurs who are currently students who are running startups mostly from the hostels come and talk about what they're doing. Right, so that's actually a presentation by your seniors, if you will, on what they're doing, and that's a chance to interact with them. Again, perhaps a chance to join them, perhaps a chance to understand how it's done. And most of these companies will be incubated very soon. Right, so that's on Thursday. And finally, on Saturday, we have two events. We have an incubation drive, where if you have a venture that you feel is close to incubation, then you can actually come and pitch in front of the incubation cell, and we'll put you on your way towards incubation. We also have a closing session in ICSR Hall 2 where both our director, Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy, and Professor Ashok Junjunwala, who is the faculty in charge of entrepreneurship, will be present. And they will, and we'll talk a little bit about what we have in store going forward. What is IIT Madras's orientation towards entrepreneurship going forward, right? So there are a series of events all week. There are posters, I believe, that are being put out and probably daily emails that are being sent on events that day. So, and of course, locations vary, timings vary, but you can get a sense for what we're doing. So hopefully, those of you who are interested in entrepreneurship, whether you have a passing interest or whether you actually have an idea that you want to start up on, hopefully all of you will come to most of the events this week and take advantage of the expertise and the resources that are being provided. And you can either come and participate actively or even just come watch, learn, talk to people. All of that is good experience for all of you, right? So welcome to eWeek, and I will ask now Baumik to introduce our panelists today. Come on.
Before I introduce our panelist, we'll just have a trailer of eWeek played. It says, we have three very experienced and seasoned entrepreneurs with us who are ready to share their knowledge and wisdom with us. First of our speaker is Mr. Murugavel Janakiraman. He is a man who needs no introduction, founder of Bharat Matrimony, which was one of the early tech startups of India and has helped millions of people to experience the joy of love and matrimony through internet. Mr. Murugavel was also honored as a top 5 Asian Indian businessman by Asian Indian Chambers of Commerce, and he was also named as the business icon of the year by India Today Group. These are some of his credentials, and Mr. Murugavel also looks forward to mentorship and helping early stage entrepreneurs. So I would like to ask Mr. Murugavel to share his knowledge with us.
So I've been asked to speak on joys and challenges of entrepreneurship. So my speech is going to revolve around the joys of being entrepreneur and some of the challenges. But I need to be politically right also, because running a matrimony site, the first joy or the foremost joys I need to say is that I got married through bharatmatrimony.com. Because go home and tell some other was the... Thank you. If you go and tell my wife that, the other thing was something, come to know that how can, you know, our marriage not being the first. So I want to just put that on the first one. Happily married for the last almost 13 and a half years. So that's the first joy, I would say that. Great. Again, it's more like a restaurant. You know, someone say that the owner of the restaurant also eats here. So I need to be the standing testimony that it works. So other thing about the joys, I'm going to, you know, kind of talk about various joys. There is a beauty in creating something out of nowhere. That's the biggest thing about entrepreneurship. You are able to see something the world has not seen. And creating something, making it successful, that's a big joy. It's more like you're giving a birth to the baby and seeing that growing and crawling, running, you know, I think that's a great joy. And we created multiple businesses. We pioneered various business models. while Bharat Matrimony was the first one we created, today within matrimony.com, we're running so many businesses. We pioneered Elite Matrimony, which is an exclusive matrimony site for rich and affluent. We pioneered something called assisted matrimony, where it's more like outsourcing of marriage. It's both the business model being pioneered by us. We also segmented matrimony based on various communities. We're running our own competition called Community Matrimony, where we have an exclusive site for every community, every religion. We are running 300 plus sites under the brand called Community Matrimony. Then we are running another business called Tambulya, which is again India's first and exclusive venture for people who want to buy the return gifts. Today is a both online and offline venture. We have three stores in Chennai offline. Again, it's an online model where people can come and buy the return gifts for any occasion, both it's a marriage, anniversary, or any occasion. We have a business called Matrimony Directory, which is a freemium business model. We have 50,000 people in the wedding letter services listed with us. That's growing very well. We recently ventured into a business called Matrimony Expo, which is an offline event where we bring all the vendors in the marriage-related space where people can walk in and avail the services they're looking for marriage. Basically, what one business of online bharatmatrimony.com, we're able to create multiple businesses. We are able to take that business to outside of India also. We launched Pakistani Matrimony, Bangla Matrimony, Sri Lankan Matrimony, Arab Matrimony. So this is a joy in creating various businesses and making it successful. It's a great joy there. And also joy in becoming the successful entrepreneur. I was a programmer when I started the business in 1997. So I started as a one-man show in 1997. 2.5 years of the one-man show. 2000, we had a small office in Chennai, 300 square feet, three people. And from that, without having any or complete understanding of business, has went on with the basic understanding of what is a business. The understanding was, technology was good understanding, innovation was there, but I didn't have the well-rounded experience of running a business. I didn't have the expertise of finance, HR, marketing, sales. Went and launched a website with the strength of programming being my strength, launched the business, so-called, because I started the business and became the founder and CEO. From that today, to see that we have 4,000 associates across India, and today we have so many vice presidents managing various businesses. Today we have all the C-level people from finance, HR, different. And see the transformation of a programmer into a CEO, that's a great job. And see that note today, that while I did not have all the understanding around the business, over a period of time, learned various expertise required to run the business. I think the joy in seeing that, you know, kind of someone growing. It's more like I'm seeing myself growing in my own eyes. That's the way it is. All the, you know, kind of, you know, years pushing myself to go to the next level, seeing myself growing. I think that's the good joy. And again, today we are a good employment to thousands of associates. Today there are 4,000 people are working for matrimony.com. When you're able to give employment to so many people, rather than being part of some own organization, we are able to create so many people able to find their livelihood through our organization. I think India needs many such entrepreneurs where you need to give, rather than you being, yes, we also need associates, but as an entrepreneur, what able to give employment to thousands of people. There's a great joy in you are able to provide employment to so many people. And also seeing people growing in our organization. Whilst I was a programmer, today become the CEO running a successful organization, was able to see, create a platform where the people were able to grow and become successful. Our chief portal officer was the first programmer to join. Today she grew and became a chief portal officer, where it's an ordinary programmer becoming a successful, one of the best talent in India, where she's managing hundreds of people in the technology and the mobile space. Not only that, we are able to create a value-based organization where people are able to grow, people are able to succeed, people are able to excel. There's a joy in creating a very successful organization, completely value-based organization, where people know in matrimony.com, values are the fundamental. very clear. In fact, one of the company what we started is IndiaProperty.com. IndiaProperty.com, we launched many verticals. During 2008, we launched so many verticals, property, jobs, automobile. While, again, it's a different story that we ventured into so many verticals when you're not really ready for that kind of management bandwidth or funding and other thing. We thought we become so successful in matrimony, we could be able to create a successful in all the other verticals. In 2008, we decided that we can't be successful in each and every vertical, given the management bandwidth or amount of capital what we add. So we decided to focus only on matrimony and property. 2009 or 10, I got a business director. I told him that you do well in India property. That time, the company called Consum. You do well, then I'll make you a CEO, and we also raise money exclusive for IndiaProperty.com. We're able to provide a platform for business yet to become a CEO. Today, IndiaProperty.com is a separate venture, well started by me. Seeing that becomes successful, we're able to create a platform and provide the opportunity.